My name is Adam McIntosh from WebSAN Solutions, and I oversee the team here that helps put together our apps and release them out to Microsoft App Stores. Today, we wanted to walk you through a quick rapid-fire session of some of the top apps that we've seen our user base take advantage of. There's obviously a large number of apps out there in the Microsoft App Store space and out there online outside of that space that you can take advantage of to extend the functionality of Business Central. We think the eight or so that we're going to walk you through today are, you know, must-haves depending on your area of focus. The first few are going to focus on distribution, and the last few will be wide-ranging and can apply to really any Business Central environment. So let's get right into it. The first app I want to review is our Supply Chain Accelerator. This is a bundle of the various enhancements we've made to the system over time. It includes usability features and reporting enhancements, and it's broken down into three different tiers. So our starter tier has a lot of focus on distribution, reporting, and some posting restrictions and workflows. The second tier, which is our premium tier, it extends a lot of the tracking functionality within the sales module, as well as adds some additional reporting to the system. And then finally, our expanded feature gets into a lot of shipping enhancements, item availability, and some pricing enhancements. The first tier is $100, the premium tier is $200, and the expanded tier is $300 per month. We have a list of all the various features on our website, so I encourage you to go check those out. The next app I want to talk about is our Sales Forecast app. And what the Sales Forecast app does is it populates the demand forecast at an item level such that you can use that for MRP. So effectively what you do is you set the look back period for it to look back in the sales, and it takes those sales, averages them by month, and then uses that to predict your future sales. Now, what we've actually recently added to the app is the Azure AI functionality, which speaks to Azure in the web, uses your existing numbers and puts those into the online models and pulls that data back down into Business Central to populate that same data at an item level. Really, really cool stuff. Let's take a look at a quick video.
So our app, what we've added here is use the AI engine for the demand forecast. So the forecast that you just saw was the forecast without the AI results being included. So I'm just going to turn that on. You can see it is November 4th. I just ran it this morning to generate the results for the AI engine. And now all we're going to do is include that in the forecast. So when we take a look at item 1000, what you can see here is the sales forecast for that item. You can see it's roughly coming out to be 176 or so a month. Now, the origination of our app was because, quite frankly, you know, this is great and all, and I can create a purchase order from here, but there's no planner on the planet that actually creates a PO by item individually looking at each item's demand. So all we've done really is we've taken this AI result, but we're going to dump it into that demand forecast that I showed you, right? So this was the version without the AI. If I now replace the sales history using the artificial intelligence data, you're going to see that number change. So we'll just give that a second here. And there's that 176.37. So essentially what you saw on that individual item has now taken place of that data for the non-AI version in that forecast for that test item, okay? And that's basically what we're doing is we're leveraging the artificial intelligence engine that Microsoft has already built into Dynamics, although they did it for an item-by-item basis. We then took that engine and we rolled it into the actual forecast. So now the whole basis for this app is that you can use artificial intelligence to now execute and drop into your demand forecast that then can be used with MRP, and we have subsequent webinars on that subject. So that's a quick demo of our app that adds artificial intelligence back in. You can run it without the AI turned on, as I showed you earlier, and it will simply do a 12-month or 24-month or however many months you want average of the demand. The AI will take seasonality and other things into account, even though for this particular item it was relatively flat. So that's why we see all these numbers agreeing. But the artificial intelligence engine will do that automatically.
All right, the next app I want to talk about is Moniroo. We've had Moniroo out for a number of years, and we actually have tens of thousands of monthly users on Moniroo today. We've got a number of different modules, and I'm going to run through a few of the major ones here. First is the manufacturing data collection. This allows you to easily input both time and inventory entries against release production orders in the system. Really useful functionality for those using the production order portion of Business Central. Next is budgeting. This is super useful for those in finance that send around their budgets to all the different department heads every year and have to correlate and collect all those budgets. They can input that data directly into Business Central, have that go through various workflows, and then get consolidated within Business Central once everyone has submitted their departmental values. The next module is the purchase requisitioning module. We've had this module for a long, long time, but I love to highlight it because it is super popular amongst our user base. It allows for automated approval routings and notifications based on various dollar thresholds, based on the project, based on departments, or based on your supervisor approval chain. You can even add automated payment methods to the PO such that when invoices come in, you can have those paid automatically by different methods in Business Central. We compare the spend on that particular line of any requisition to budgets, and we can even do buyer consolidation at the end if you have multiple purchase orders for similar products and for similar vendors. Very, very popular module. Definitely take a look at it. And last but not least is our time and expense module. This, like all the other modules, interacts directly with Business Central to automatically pull in your jobs and your tasks and your planning lines on those jobs. Allows you to put in time expenses for reimbursement that's available over the web and on a mobile device. Within the mobile device, we also have OCR and time off requests as well for those people heading out of office. Now, if entering data on the web isn't your thing, EDI is the next best thing. It automatically populates data from any of your trading partners. We've got an EDI app that connects in natively with Business Central. Out of the box, we've got 30 trading partners already, or actually well over 30 trading partners, including a few that I've highlighted here, like Amazon, Home Depot, Loblaws, Nordstrom, and Wayfair. We have a number of different transaction types. We actually support more than the half dozen or so I've listed on the window here. And I wanted to take a quick look at a video we recorded that walks you through some of the EDI functionality. So let's play that now.
So here's a quick run through of kind of how the application works. So the top flow here is kind of a generic perspective on that. Bottom is a specific example with 850. So fundamentally, the trading partner sends or receives data through a network. Our app picks up the trading partner or Business Central data, depending on which way it's going. So if we go left to right, that's into Business Central. Right to left is out of Business Central to the trading partner. So if we go left to right, trading partner sends that data. We pick it up and perform the data transformation. If any of you have ever seen raw EDI data, it's pretty complex to even look at as a human being. So we take care of all that translation, obviously. And then that data comes into Business Central, is stored as an input queue or a staging queue, and then those transactions are performed. Now, all that's done automatically. We can also do it manually. For today's purpose, I'll actually be doing it manually just as a demo, but it's typically done automatically by the system. Okay. If it's outbound, that data is marked for pickup. As an example, 810 being an invoice, that's getting, when I process that sales order here in the demo to come, you'll see that get processed into an 810, ready to get pushed out automatically. That data is pushed and pulled from, pulled out of Business Central almost near real time and sent through to the trading partner. Okay, so that's kind of a generic flow. If we take a look at a very specific example with 850, so a customer of ours, their customer sends in a purchase order via an 850, which then we receive in our app in Business Central from our gateway and stages it in a queue. I think the queue can be it can be run as often as you like. Typically, we schedule it every 30 minutes, but that's controlled via configuration settings in Business Central by our customers in the EDI 365 app. As an example, then that purchase order, that 850, is then brought into Business Central as a sales order. They process it, ship it, pick it, pack it, print labels, whatever it is they need to do, and then that is processed into an invoice. And in this example, an 856 can be sent out, which was an ASN. or an 810 being that invoice. It's triggered in Business Central. That EDI gateway or application is constantly pulling the database, and then we transform it and send that data out to the end customer, so our customer's customer, if you will. So fairly straightforward when you think about it, but if you're familiar with EDI, a lot of moving parts along the way for sure, and a lot of configuration options, a lot of mapping, et cetera, that goes along with it. Even error handling as well, which we do, which I'll show you here in a moment. So let's dive right into our demo here. First thing I want to do is we're going to go and just start at the beginning and kind of show you the EDI application settings. Now, that being said, when I come into Business Central and I just search for the word EDI, you'll see those list of transactions. There's that 856, 810. So even if you wanted to see the data in the staging tables before they go out, they are all accessible via in Business Central. And I'll show you the 850s here in just a moment. But for now, what I'm going to do is go to our application settings, because a lot of customers who approach us for EDI have obviously some questions on what it can, can't do. And the first question usually is, how the heck do you handle any errors? And that very first setting you're going to see here, so for 850s, inbound purchase orders to sales orders, we can configure multiple people to send those error messages to so they can deal with them. And I'll show you here shortly the staging table you come into Business Central to deal with any of those errors.
All right, so if you're not using EDI to process your transactions automatically, a barcode scanner within your warehouse might be the next best thing. Barcode scanning significantly improves your inventory controls. In this case, we have a scanner that works for all the various phases of an item's life cycle, from bringing it in, so doing your PO receipt, moving it around the warehouse, so doing your bin movements, any even RMAs or returns back to your vendors as well. We'll process all those. Within the warehouse, we move data around. So we'll do your bin moves, your warehouse to warehouse transfers. We handle lot tracking, even your cycle counts as well. And then obviously your outbound pick, pack, and ship process. So we support wave picking, batch picking, and various integrations to third parties as well. Next is our vendor contract app. We've actually had a lot of customers ask us about this app. It allows you to track your spend with vendors over long periods of time. What's really great about this app is it allows you to track key dates, so any notification periods, any renewal periods that you might need to know for a contract. It allows you to manage those. It'll actually integrate your purchases and allow you to better manage your spend and your commitments to your various vendors. Because keep in mind, a lot of the contracts you might have with vendors might span 4, 5, 6 plus years, and you need to know what all those commitments you've made are. Last, obviously, any clauses. So if you have termination clauses, notice criteria for cancellation, so on and so forth, you can track that all within the app and, again, get the proper notifications. Workflows. So next is workflows. Everyone loves workflows. That's one of the great benefits of using Business Central, is it has a lot of standard workflows built into the system. We've actually piggybacked off of those workflows and that functionality that the system has, and we've added additional functionality. In our case, we allow for group-based approvals, multiple tiers of groups, different chains and levels of command that can be utilized within the approval process. We have admin approvals, and to wrap it all together, custom notifications depending on where you are in the approval process. So again, we piggyback off that existing functionality and just expand it to areas the system doesn't traditionally support. The last app I'm going to talk about today is our electronic banking app. Every business in today's world needs a way to automatically generate your payment files from your bank. It dramatically reduces errors and allows you to automatically send payments en masse to your partners. We have an app that is $50 per month, and it supports various banking formats from various banks. I definitely recommend that as part of your standard Dynamics package. So that's all we have for today. Wanted to give you a quick rundown of some of our top apps. We obviously don't have time to demo every single app. Hopefully a couple that we did demo give you a good feel for some of the functionality we've built that extends the Business Central system. If you want to talk about some of these apps further in more detail, please feel free to email us at info@websand.com, and I look forward to answering some of your questions in the Q&A.